Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in mortality, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And know that gospel is not for everyone, it's for 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. So many people, you know, don't care, they just go to the church or any other places for social gathering and not to learn anything. When they suffer, then they cry, you know, and they, oh God, God, what God can do? Prayer and fasting are anti-Christ, because that prayer and fasting used to be under rabbis. After John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16, there is no more prophet and no more prayer and fasting or rabbis. So we are royal priests. Unless you become a royal priest, you can't preach gospel. Here I am rendering exposition of John Gospel, John 11, verse 17 to 27. When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Four has a special significance, and it makes sense over here, because there are 4 days make sense as we have 4 spiritual states that are ego, of flesh, that mind, then we become clever, and the doubting type, like Judas Iscariot was led for mind, and he went for mammon. Wisdom, those who are sealed to serve God. Thomas, also doubting, but sealed to serve God, not greedy, not stealing, honest. And then we have will, which is the very greatest, and that gave you the Holy Spirit with a capital S. The same as Jesus. At Pentecost, all the 12 got the reward, not wage, reward of our gift of Holy Spirit from our Father. And all became the twin brethren of Jesus. So Thomas is called a twin brother, but he wasn't twin in this sense. He was twin spiritually, that everything he will know, he tried to know the basic, not just take it. He wanted to know everything from the fundamental, as Jesus was preaching, from the very basic. So he also wanted to learn everything from basic. That's why he was questioning type, but believing. And also we have four ages. We have the Satyug, in which all are saint. Then we have Treta, when mercy is lost. Then we have Dwapar, and then we have this dark age of Christ, when the rabbi become blind, spiritually blind, and they can't leave their disciples anywhere, and they become crook. And then Christ comes. This is the age of Christ, in which you become the Son of the Most High. So Lazarus was in the fourth highest spiritual state, the Son of the Most High, as Jesus himself was. That made him his friend, and so were Jesus' laborers employed in the vineyard of our Father. This is the vineyard, this word, and we are employed as a laborer to fish, fishes of men, this world at large. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, some 2 miles away, and many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them about their brother. I think Lazarus belonged to Judah tribe, and Jerusalem was dominated by this tribe. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him. So she went and met him, you know, that she knew the power of Jesus because she has seen the miracles. Martha was once born, and Mary Magdalene was twice born. So she could understand gospel. Martha could not understand gospel like Peter, you know. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him while Mary stayed at home. Mary was confident that once you preach gospel by the grace of our Father, then God looks after you, that you are his representation, you are his son. Once you start preaching gospel, then when you are his son, then you don't die. Martha was once born like Peter. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been," that means she was once born, and so she wanted to say, you know, that, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Like, she knew that he performed miracle, the Son of God, as Nicodemus knew that unless you are from God, you can't perform these miracles. Nicodemus also was once born, but clean-hearted. No hypocrisy in him. Like a little child, his heart was. So was Peter. But even now, I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him. You know, the people, sometimes they love this flesh. Somebody is white person will love his white person and discriminate against black because they belong to different color. But here, the soul, which is of our supernatural Father inside us, is the real self. And without this soul inside you, this is good for nothing. This is just a pot, earth to earth. So that's what here it is, you know. I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him. That means the family, all the poor, loved each other, unlike the rich hating each other out of jealousy. You will find among the poor, if somebody is sick, everybody help him, you know. Among the rich, if somebody is poor or sick, they are always thinking, "Let him die and I want to buy his house." And they are always thinking in that material term, jealousy. Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live, and everyone who lives and believes in me will never die." So do you believe this? Now this Messianic Jew, you know, people of Judah tribe, they added extra stuff into it. And you have to be careful, you know. So this is a bit psycho-fancy. Messianic Jews did some extras, but never mind. She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." Now, you know, the Lord has slaves and Father has sons. When we have son of one father, we have brethren. So Jesus, for the twice born people, he was a brother. But for the once born, because he was performing miracles and all that, master of the nature, he came from supernatural Father. So they, for them it was Lord, you know, like Yahweh is the Lord. So never mind. This is the people who, Peter also used this term, Lord. under rabbis, people did works or karma, and they earned the next rebirth. You know, in Adam, we are born and die, because Adam is not eternal. Everything that is born is to die, even plants, trees, etc. Whilst in Jesus, are our Father God in spirit, you become sons of Most High, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. They are same meaning, you know, etc. And you become eternal like our Father, and this is called resurrection, rest, salvation, redemption. So Jesus came to redeem us, you know. So into the our Father's house again, because Thomas said, you know, first you were one with our Father God, and then you became two. Two mean separated from Him. Our soul came into this earth. So when you have become two, what will you do? We will try to work hard to be back to our Father again, to house. That is called salvation. So in Nanak was the second coming of Jesus, and his philosophy is deeper than what Jesus preached, because Jesus' laborers are the people, laborers. Jesus had workers, laborers, twice born. Once born could not understand gospel. They were of a very, very low understanding. That time the Satan wasn't that strong. That's why Jesus called people of Judah tribe the princes of darkness. Princes mean baby. And when Jesus rebuked Judah Iscariot for stealing and for all that money, for the sake of money, love of money, he was friend of temple priest and talking against Jesus. So that's why he was thrown out of the Last Supper. Go and get lost. And this is mentioned in the parable of the marriage of the son. One man was not properly dressed, and when father came, he said, "Hey, what day you come into this banquet when you are not properly dressed?" Then he was thrown out of the banquet, and that was Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. So these people, dark-colored people, they are similar, you know. Judas Iscariot used to steal from the purse which the people donated money, and he used to steal money from that purse. And these dark-colored priests, people donate in the churches, and they dip the hand at the end of the month to take it as their salary. And then, because they are working for Mammon, they give you sugar-coated sermons that pleases everyone. So falsehoods kill people in millions, and that is why these sectarian riots in the Middle East and other things, because there the dark-colored priest, which Jesus got rid of them, because no dark-colored priest was needed after John the Baptist. John the Baptist or the prophet, they act like whip. Their whip is only there when you have somebody to apply the whip, like parliamentarian whip. If there is no parliament, then there will be no whip. Or if there is no whip, there is no parliament. So John the Baptist was the last whip. So after that, we don't need these dark-colored priests or rabbis, because there is no whip to whip them. They don't care. So that's why it is the time of Christ, in which everyone has to make his own effort to know gospel through ask, seek, and knock. If you're not asking questions, you are dead. A dead man can't ask questions. A living always asks questions. So be living in spirit, and then you will get resurrection. Now the second coming of Jesus was Nanak in India in 1469. And he clearly stated about what was the reincarnation, which is a rebirth in another form. Resurrection, you are not born again because you become eternal like your eternal father. So he says, karmi ave kapda. Kapda means this. This is the birth. Nadri mohdwa. By grace, you find the salvation or rest. So, seek gospel and remember that those people who are turban and beard, they call themselves Sikhs, but they hardly know any gospel. They all go there, chant and other thing, but they can't come to your church to explain to you any parables. So what type of knowledge is that if they can't use it? This Samaritan woman at the well, which had five husbands, they are well known in Sikhism. Or in Christianity, they say in a house, this is the house, there are five, three against two, two against three. Three are of ego, two are of mind. They fight with each other. Mind means greedy people, and three mean simpletons. The greedy people always cheat the simpletons, and then they kill them, you know, at the end when they become rich. So this is the gospel, and hope you enjoy it. If anything I can do, please let me know, and also put light on lampstand. When you have light on lampstand, then anybody seeking light will knock on your shoulder to ask you question. But don't throw pearls before swine as the Jehovah's Witness people do, knocking at the door. Same was the man locked in the graveyard in Gennesaret, where Jesus drowned 2,000 swine. He was, you know, like Jehovah's Witness. He was stopping people, telling them our rabbi is a crook, you know, exposing his hypocrisy and all that. But people were spiritually blind. They were studious of the rabbi. They were frightened to talk anything except what their rabbi tell them to do, like these abbots in the monasteries. They have the same power as the rabbis had, stronger than that. They fulfill Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the arid spirit. They are arid spirit people. They make their disciple dumb and deaf to know anything else than what they tell you. That is what dumb and deaf mean. And Jesus said, open your ears, listen to everyone, and wet them in spirit. Holy Spirit is common sense. So our Father God blesses you.